Today, we're gonna do an amazing stretch where you need a wall and a mat, and that's it. And if you've never done this before, it is amazing. You wanna get your butt as close as you can to the wall. It's a little awkward to get there, but once you get there, it's not awkward for me because I do the stretch all the time. Legs straight, hands are down. Typically, all day long, our blood is flowing this way. To take the pressure off your legs and have the blood flow down this way is amazing. If you have any kind of low back pain, this is a great hamstring stretch. And you might even want to just stay here for the whole 10 minutes. You might be like, Pam, I am great right here. I just want you to feel amazing in the stretch. I also want you to breathe. This might be a little uncomfortable if you're not used to stretching, and you might be pursing your lips and thinking, I can't bear it. Hang in there, it will get better, and your body will learn to love the stretch. Now, I did not make this up. I actually saw this on a Fit Radio stretching, I can't say workout, segment. And I started to do it, and if you have 5 minutes, if you have 1 minute and just want to stretch for 1 minute, this would be an amazing one to do. Now from here, I want you to put, you can scoop back a little bit. I want you to put one foot on the wall and bring your other foot on top of your knee. Now, if you do yoga, this is like a pigeon pose against the wall. If you're normally on the mat, it gets your glute and your hip. Now, you might start here and be like, I'm good. If you need a deeper stretch, if your hips are not tight, the more you work your foot down the wall, the deeper that stretch gets. If you want it even deeper, you can press your knee away from you. Keep breathing, keep breathing. The more that foot comes down the wall, the deeper the stretch is in that opposite hip. This is one of the, I think, most important stretches for many people, because a lot of us have tight hips and tight hamstrings and tight glutes, and this gets that whole area. You just gotta breathe through it. It's hard for people to get into pigeon on the mat. They don't have the flexibility, but everybody can do this because you can start here and that might be enough for you if you've never stretched before. And then as you get more flexible, you can bring your foot a little bit lower, and work it down the wall. Now give me one deep breath right here. Okay, let's switch sides. And we're gonna start up. That foot is against an opposite knee. If you feel the stretch here, stay here. Everybody is different. Bring that foot down until you feel an amazing stretch. It should be right down there. Holy moly. If you need it a little bit deeper, remember you can press that foot, press your knee away from you, and that'll make that stretch just a little bit deeper. If you're swearing at me right now, I'm totally good with that, because I only want you to feel amazing. In fact, I just did this whole circuit with a class on Sunday, and I have a guy who's a regular bike rider. He said it was the best ride he's had in years because he rode after the stretch class and his body felt amazing. So even though it might be uncomfortable while you're doing it, I promise your body will totally love it and you'll feel better afterwards. Come a little bit lower if you can, and let's take one deep breath right here. Let's come back up with both feet up on the wall. And I just want you to let your legs drop however far out is comfortable for you. Please do not compare yourself to me, because I've been stretching for 40 years, seriously. Go until you feel a nice stretch in your inner thighs, which we do use every single day, I promise. And we're just hanging out here. Who knew the wall could be so helpful in our stretching? Oh my gosh. We haven't even done any upper body stretching against the wall. There's a ton we can do, but today we're just gonna do lower body stretching. Because most of the time, our back hurts because our hamstrings are tight. And we use our legs every day when we're walking, when we're moving. We only use our arms really when we're working out or carrying kids or groceries. But it doesn't necessarily, the stretching doesn't affect our upper body like it does our lower body. Take one deep breath in right here. And drop those legs even a little bit lower. We're gonna scoot a little bit away from the wall. Bring one foot down, the opposite foot on your knee. If you want to, stretch that knee up. But remember, if you feel the stretch up here, stay there. Only if you don't feel it. Bring that foot down until you feel a beautiful stretch in your hamstring and your hip and your glute, all that. And keep breathing. Remember, every time you're on the ground, I want your head on the mat. Never try to come up like that. Oh, no, no. That puts so much strain on your neck, and I really want to protect your neck muscles because it stinks when your neck hurts. It really does. Anyway, let's take one deep breath in right here. And breathe out. I lied in a good way. One more deep breath in. And breathe out. Let's switch sides. Remember, we're coming down to the stretch until you feel it. And the more you do this, much like your strength training, the more you do this, the more flexible you're gonna get. I think it's so funny when people say, Pam, I'm just not flexible. And then I say, do you stretch? And they say, no. Well, you gotta stretch if you wanna be flexible. I've met very few people in 20 plus years of doing this that are naturally flexible. One or two, and one of those is double jointed. That probably helps. Flexibility, if you work on it, even a couple minutes a day makes a huge difference. Okay, this is a nice part. Close your eyes. If you want to press that knee out for more flexibility, great. We're gonna take two deep breaths right here. Last one right here. Scoot that butt back towards that wall. We're gonna bring our legs out one more time, just until you feel a nice stretch. And try not to tense your muscles. You're letting everything relax. Hands are down. We're gonna take three deep breaths right here, and that will be it for the stretch. Three deep breaths. Bring those legs up, and you're thinking, how I'm so comfortable and relaxed, how do I get out of this? You're gonna scoot away a little bit. You're gonna bring your knees down to the side and push yourself up. I hope you feel as amazing as I do, and I hope you come back and do this again soon. Have an amazing rest of your day.